everyone. I am Wen Yili. Welcome to Taiwan is my home. Speaking of Taiwan, although the area of land is not too big, it is a place for many people fulfilling their dreams, like a chef, as long as he has the determination he could be a dance teacher. Like this overseas Chinese man Ma Ching Hong, originally he came to Taiwan for studying college. He worked as a part-time chef in a restaurant. Unexpectedly, he fell in love with the passion of Latin dance. Some people even wanted to learn dance from him. After several years, he decided to quit chef.Concentrate on teaching dancing. He said if he had the chance, he'd go back to Myanmar. He will tell people in his hometown, Taiwan is the place to let him know that life had unlimited possibilities. Passionate Rumba dance that Ma Ching Chong enchanted. Beside being a dance judge, he also liked to teach dancing more. Okay, our first movement, 5, 6, 7, 8, done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. Cross the legs over your partner knees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The story of falling in love with dancing could be traced back to 16 years ago. Ma, as an overseas Chinese in Myanmar, went to college in Taiwan to save the living cost. He worked as a cook and volunteer in summer holidays. This sportful guy followed his friends to learn about dancing and fascinated at Latin dance. Once at a light club, he danced salsa. He became a dance teacher since.There was one time I went to nightclub with friends. Many Taiwanese friends saw me dance in salsa and was very self-fascinated to it. They liked it a lot. They asked me, Xiao Ma, have you ever taught dance? I said I was a teacher, but I was not a dance teacher, but I said I was a cook. They said, it's okay. We'll help you to find a place. In the Eastern area, there's a dance class. We'll help you to find them. Then I started teaching.At that time, Ma was a cook. Each month only had 4 days off to teach dance, but he'd never complained, but become more determined to dance. Students become more and more. They are intended to learn various dance. At that time, I found that my capability was not enough. What should I do? Then I just had to make a very important decision to quit the chef job. Then I spent 2 years to specialize in teaching dance to see whether I can turn this hobby to a profession. Then in 2 years, I succeeded. Then I kept the ongoing training step by step up to now. Set up my own studio and set up a dancing association.3, 2, go, 3, 2, 5, 6, 7, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 4, go slow, slow, emotion. Turning to dancing teacher from a cook, Ma separates each movement of Latin dance. Even a student just starts learning dancing could get the tip quickly.Like when I just came here, my first lesson, I had learned some basic movements immediately. Of course, for proficiency, I have to practice more. But with his guidance, your body would naturally move it very quickly. Yeah, and you won't feel embarrassed at all. Regarding embarrassment, because Ma is good at Latin dance, which kind of passionate dance? Most of the dance are closed dance to show personal charisma and the rhythm of Ma's movements, that's the classroom, full of fervor. However, Ma's professional teaching attitude seems to cut out of the invasions of desires, and all the students are awash in the dance of passion.I think since Ma is a foreigner and his ideas and logic would be different from us, and in fact, it makes the classroom filled with atmosphere of diversities. In this classroom, I got more chances to get in touch with salsa dance. Actually, I think the dance I danced before is not ballroom dancing. It is more formal. Now I come here, I could understand more like social with people. This is the kind of dance with interaction.Because one salsa dance, Ma entered the world of dancing and spectability, so he keeps learning teaching. Even when the music changed, he could still move his body with passion in his favorite dancing world.
姐。
哎，冰来吧，千雄。哎，铁板回来。
OK，
先来来。
Although he is not a chef anymore, Ma is not a strategic person. He visited his ex-boss very often because to him it was a place to make him a poor student to support his life. And when Ma is at this restaurant, his boss has already noticed his talent of dancing. What I could remember is I often saw him on his way to work, humming and dancing to the restaurant, yes. Did he dance in the kitchen too? Yes, he did.In the hot and busy kitchen, it is easy for people to fight with each other, but Ma's personality is gentle and peaceful. He never quarreled with others. He always listened to the music, spinning and dancing lightly. He used his way to interpret his each dishes while his cells are dancing. Yes, so I think it's really good, and he has the sense of art. In fact, when he worked as a cook for me, the dishes he plated, when you see the plating, you would know he knew which dish would match with which leaves. And the dish that he matched is very beautiful because our dish is more delicate, would match with some flowers or leaves. I think he did quite well. I didn't have to teach him. He could do it very well.Even though he was not a cook for many years, Ma will still cook once in a while to memorize those days in the kitchen. What I am making now is Myanmar salad. The difference between Thai salad and this is because Yangon in Myanmar, its latitude is 5 and very close to the equator, so the weather is very hot. So therefore their taste will be very spicy. Like local Myanmar people, when they eat with raw peppers directly. Relatively speaking, it's more spicy than Thai cuisine. In addition to Myanmar cuisine, the must-have shrimp fried cakes in the Thai restaurant was the classical dishes that Ma had to make every day. Because fried shrimp cake, if you don't leave some spaces for it, one, it will burn easily, two, it will expand easily.Just let the air out? Yes, let the air out and it was evenly heated. Its shape won't be changed easily when it's fried. In the kitchen, Ma deliberately explained the keywords of Myanmar cuisine before he came to Taiwan. He never cooked before because since he was little, his parents only expected him to study college in Taiwan. When he really became a college student in Taiwan, what was waiting for him was a shocking testing. That year, he just arrived in Nantou. He registered in Jinan University. After 1 week, 921 earthquake occurred. I didn't know what was going on me. We ran to the field from 5th floor.In 20 seconds, it is the image that the scene you saw on TV, which is things falling down from the ceilings. From ceilings, yes, the scenes like that. Unfortunately, our school was newly built. Because our school was new, relatively it was stronger, but all the equipment were crushed. So the whole school was crashed. Also, because we're located in two mountains, the main road were all split and we could connect people with outside. Therefore, during those days, we're really terrified. All the teachers and students depended on airdrop supplies for 6 days. This experience in the earthquake stricken area is remains fresh in Ma's memories.He was laughing and saying that if the bridge didn't break, he'd probably pack his stuff and go back to Myanmar immediately. On the day I really wanted to go home, I was thinking, wow, am I not coming here for study? How come it becomes like this? 2 hours ago, I was still very happy in orientation, and 2 hours later, things like this happened. First, I could leave.But I couldn't leave. Second, I thought that if I spend a lot of money and with the expectations from parents to come to Taiwan for study, I didn't want to give up just because of this. If I couldn't, yes, I have to be tough. After the earthquake, life was going back to normal. Usually, he had class in Nantou Puli. During the summer and winter vacations, Ma didn't have extra money to go back to Myanmar. He had to go to Taipei for a part-time job. He chose a hard job to work in the restaurant because he didn't want to be an economical burden to his family. In Taiwan, what kind of job would let you earn your life expense and tuition expense for 1 year? In only 3 months, it's very hard, but being a cook can make it. The salary is at least more than $30,000 and almost $40,000. Yes, if you did it long enough, it's about $40,000, more than $100,000 for tuition. Tuition for 2 semesters is supposedly enough. With life expense and things like being changed wouldn't happen because cook is the kind of job with professional skills. From a student to a cook to a dance teacher, Maslach is like serendipity, but it is reasonable. His deep gratitude to Taiwan because of the conservative Myanmar that is impossible for him to experience to this special life. It makes my life extraordinary. This is what I think it might be like ordinary, but relatively speaking, in a person's life, it is hard to experience such a big accident like 9-1 earthquake, and it's hard to become a chef. And from a man who don't know how to cook, a man who didn't know how to dance and become a dancing teacher, things like this, it is impossible to happen to me in Myanmar. It is not allowed to happen. Ma spoke directly in the traditional and prostitutive Myanmar. Dancing to a man is against traditions. Even nowadays, his parents in Myanmar, it's still hard to accept that their son's job is a dancing teacher. Ma says that being able to choose his life freely is the happiest part to be a Taiwanese. Staying in Taiwan for almost 16 years, now my lifestyle and attitude is totally like a Taiwanese. Yes, if I had the chance 2 years in the future, I hope to go to Myanmar and promote and share the food and culture of Taiwan. A few years ago, Myanmar started to reform and reopen. Ma also hopes to have the chance to go to his hometown to tell others that Taiwan is the place that let him know that life could have unlimited possibilities. As long as you're willing, you will have extraordinary experience. In Taiwan, everyone should hear that Chang Xiaoyan, the mother of entertainment TV shows, but maybe you don't know there's another Chang Xiaoyan in Inga, come from a Hakka village in Fujian, got married in Taiwan. His mother-in-law was a ceramic artist. To fulfill their mother's wish, the couple grit their teeth to set up a ceramics factory. Starting from zero, his husband is in charge of production and she is responsible of marketing and product management. They hope to use their own mercury alum dyeing skill to start their ceramic life. Because our items are more delicate, if we found out there's a tiny defect, we will be very struggling inside whether we should let that pass or not. But at that moment, I will stick one of my leaf. I want the quality of my products will be the best and perfect. What she insisted is the kind of handmade painting skill to metallize the surface of ceramic. It's the technique of mercury alum guiding skill. The process of production is very complicated to make it a simple ceramic, golden and shining. From Shujian Hoka village, Chang Xiaoyan had married in Taiwan for more than 8 years with husband in Yingge area to run a ceramic factory. From knowing nothing about ceramics, she could pass the steps into this field because of the couple's filial piety. Like this is a blue and white dragon drew by my mother-in-law. You could see the head of the dragon drew by her. It's very clear that the claws is very strong and powerful. She didn't make any draft, she just painted it on directly. Her mother-in-law was an outstanding ceramic artist, loved ceramic all her life. When Chang Xiaoyan just got married, her mother-in-law wanted her to work in the ceramic factory together and planned to pass all her painting skills to her. Chang was very touched in her heart and wanted to learn very much, but the awkward situation was she and her husband were in debt. In order to repay the debt, Chang had no choice but to work in the technology company with high salary and planned that after cleaning the debt, she could start leaning painting for her mother-in-law. However, she would never wait for this year day. She used to tell me that she will teach me. until 2013, my husband and I finally repaid all the debt. I was planning to learn painting, but in April 2014, my mother-in-law suddenly passed away. My husband is also fearful for his succession after mom's crafts, so he decided to set up his own factory. To show their gratitude to their mom, the couple decided to walk on their senior's path of life. According to her husband, his family mostly work in ceramic field. Clay making is not difficult, but to Chang, she had to learn from zero. To fulfill mom's wish to promote what she did and the inheritance of ceramic, Chang quitted her original job and started the business of ceramic. To start from zero. At first, of course, she didn't know anything. We taught her patiently. One of my deepest memory was when I learned to run also. In fact, it also means that we should use the water of mercury, alkalum, gilding, drawing lines on the body. That part was hard for me. I had to start over every time I ruined it. Wiping it for 40 or 50 times a day, keeping starting all over again, thinking about the golden water caused a lot. A thrill went through her. Every time she wiped it off, her heart hurts. At that time, I felt very painful because our gold water is very expensive. It's the real gold water. So I really wanted to give up. I didn't want to learn. I told my husband that if I keep doing like this, I think our business would be ruined by one. The couple takes over the jobs of factory. Her husband is responsible for products and she's busy for marketing and quality controls. At her leisure, she would learn all the kinds of knowledge of ceramic from the masters in the factory. Her husband is her most strict teacher. You see this, it will flow. You add too much water. When it tilts, it will touch the side. Don't let it touch the side. See, hold like this. The body, the bottom should be tilted like this. When we hold it steady, the bottom should be inserted like this. Insert in this way. And it means that side will be higher, yes. Let me try again. See it if it's right or not, okay? Don't tilt like this and hold the side higher. Each step of ceramic mating, Chang was under hard labor with full effort. She also used her creativity to make her own products, working so hard because she didn't want to leave her and her mother-in-law's any regrets. I want to keep breaking through myself to create something new and fresh. I wish someday I would be like my mother-in-law, very professional, and would create such crafts. Their factory had settled down not for a year. In order to raise their reputation, their products should be always innovative and revolutionary. Don't take any chance to attend the expedition. To begin new beginner of ceramics, the huge tension of Chang is expanded. It is a three-dimensional, so we call it 3D Fahua color. And our Fahua color is more special because we have a mercury alkaline gliding skill. Our mercury alkaline dialing, it will be more delicate with all kinds of lucky patterns. In this vase, I have a faith on it. It has the skill of layers, our skill in blue and white. So therefore, we decided to attend the expedition with this vase. At first, during the expedition, I was very afraid. Because I never attended before, on the expedition day, I was very nervous. My husband just sat next to me and encouraged me. He said, okay, all right, no matter if it succeeds or fails, as long as we try, it is enough. I think the happiest thing is, well, every guest they passed by, they will stop and watch. They said their items are truly beautiful. During the expedition, their product is recognized, and this made her faith grow. But as a Chinese, her identity would be questioned sometimes, and Chang always felt sad and gloomy. When I promote out products, many people will think because I am from China, the items must be made in China. At this kind of moment, I used to be very discouraged. My husband just keep in comforting me, he said there's all kinds of people in the world. We don't let others' words to hinder our original heart of true business. Her husband not only fully supported her, he also take Hakka Tuolo, which is Chang's hometown, as a major theme to relieve her homesick. This is the work that I'm going to use to attend expedition. There's a Tuolo. Its name is Zheng Cheng Lo. It has the hometown of my Tuolo from Yingting country. Although there's many important things in the factory needed to be held by her husband, they started the business together, keeping the goal in the same goal. She is her husband's spiritual support already. Xiao Yan comes to the factory, really encouraged me a lot spiritually. Sometimes when I go work out late, she never goes home first. She's always staying here to accompany me. Although she couldn't do my job, she is still by my side.After a busy day at work, Zhang has goes home. It's also the same efforts, recalling that year they got married in China. After the child was born, husband came to Taiwan first to apply the visa for his wife and son, and it took them half year to apply the visa. Because my parents kept thinking what was going on, how would it take 6 months and not done yet? Would he lie to me? I was very struggling, but in the end, I chose to believe my husband.After the child was 6 months old, I would bring my child with from China. But it is the time for Chang to face the problem of adoption. Unfamiliar place and language barriers, Chang has spoken Hakka since she was little. Her husband's family speaks mainly Taiwanese, but because of the language barrier, she always felt lonely. When I have homesick, my husband always be my side.All my emotions, my husband will be willing to share with me. I could feel my husband's sincerity and the cuteness of my child. I would take those as my strength. Let me fry it. You should add more oil and flip it over, that it won't be sticky. Like this? You should flip over like this. It won't be sticky.With hearts, everything would change. With longer time, with hard effort and loyalty, that change gave gradually, the estrangement is eliminated. The relationship of this family is getting closer and closer. Like my father-in-law is good at cooking, so often I go to the kitchen to learn cooking from my father-in-law. Not to mention being filial, everything Chang did for her father-in-law, her husband knows all of it and keeps those in his mind.There used to be a period my mom's condition is not that good. It's about 2 or 3 years ago. But for Xiao Yan, after one busy day, everybody is tired. She went out to buy a kind of oil to massage my mom for many days. Every day she is busy like a bee, but her life is productive and happy. Regarding the family across the street,There was always the biggest concern for Chang. She wants to go home and visit them, which is her most luxurious dream. I want to go home. I have to consider it carefully. When I miss my parents, I would make a phone call for them. Understanding Chang was too busy to live for their business and family, Mr. Chang misses his daughter too. He decided to come to Taiwan in person to visit his precious daughter. When she went to Taiwan, we all felt reluctant to let her go such a far place. However, seeing her in these years, her life condition, her adaptation to the environment, everything is much better, and we feel more relieved.These 8 years, Chang, with her greatest sincerity, integrated in Taiwan and very dedicated to follow mom's efforts in order to create a brand new world. And first, I didn't get used to the life in Taiwan at first to blend in this family. Now I had already loved this family deeply. With the open of society, the new inhibitors in Taiwan is more and more diversified. Now in Taiwan, every 8 newborn babies, there's one baby of new Taiwanese, which is called as one new second generation. Many people might not know that the stage of new generation go up. There are many untold stories and experience that someone decided to writing for herself that she interviews another new second generation. She seems to look for the roots in her mom.
Itu aja. Hah? Bilang. Nah, empin.
Empin, Mbak.
Kasih satu. Kamu kasih satu. Kasih kamu. Ini apa cuma saya kira saya dua orang. Kasih satu. Saya baru goreng.
As long as it's not a rainy day, Wu Zaijun always goes to nearby like this, like for frying friends. I don't have to work today, I just come here to take a walk to get to know them. Just sit down and introduce to her that I was from Indonesia too. She doesn't know they don't dare to ask me. I told them the language that you speak I could understand, I was from there too.They're all frightened. The friends Wu was talking about are those who take care of elderly in Taiwan for not too long but could only communicate with simple Mandarin. Indonesian migrant workers, how long have you been here?
Well, about 11 months speaking Mandarin. Just about. She had come to half year, she could speak a little Mandarin.
To her and from Indonesia, the one they will never talk for, in a part of foreign land, become the hometown fellows. Before 29 years, Wu had used her hometown language. Although she looks like a Chinese, she was talking to those fellows. There's a familiarity between them, just like she found her memory of her childhood and young age, and only when she was in the park, she would speak Indonesian language.How much for 1 kg? I want to buy from here. This one is fresher, very fresh. Different weight, I would buy this for one. Wu's grandfather at Qing Dynasty at 200 years ago from Guangdong moved to Indonesia, which is Borneo. Born in Indonesia, in addition to Indonesian language, she also speaks Hakka and Hokkien. But after she come to Taiwan, she lives in Sanchong, where Taiwanese is mainly spoken. To Wu, every time she goes out, she could understand at all.Sometimes it is more difficult. I just come here for some difficult words. I couldn't understand those difficult words. You couldn't understand. They couldn't understand. He probably couldn't understand too a little bit. Because when I just come here, there's difference between Indonesian and Chinese. Do you know?It's not like when I didn't talk, people will ask me. Now people may ask me.He will ask me that, do you come from China? No one will ask me whether I come from Indonesia or Southeast Asia. Not understanding for 1 or 2 days, gradually she could understand. Hearing Taiwanese for 30 years, now when she goes to grocery shopping on the street, even though there are some words she couldn't understand, it wouldn't affect her communication with others. I will buy some guavas to home. How much is the fruit? From Yanqiao. Huh?Those from Yanqiao. How much for 1 kg? One for $60. Oh, no, wait. This color is more beautiful. This color is very bright. What you're wearing is nice. You could also wear this with a narrower style. It will be similar to what I'm wearing. Yes, I'm pretty much the same.When she was 12 years old, violent Chinese exclusion incident happened to Indonesia. Chinese lost their houses. Wu and her family only brought their pots and clothes, fled to their relatives' house by bus, and moved to Jakarta, the capital. Most of their relatives were running factories. They all had Indonesian drivers. There were less Indonesian farmers as maids in their house. But rampant racism in Indonesia was intense and becomes the reason for Chinese to fled away. So was Wu Zaijun.Welcome home. Come, let me help you. Taken down first.
Wu came to Taiwan when she was 29 years old, married to a Fujian veteran, and her daughter Wu Yuzhen when she was 30. Though she was a past life experience when she came to Taiwan, that means without saying she is from Indonesia. Because of my mom's accent, people would say, Madam, you're not Taiwanese, right? And this time she wouldn't say I'm an Indonesian Chinese. She usually says, oh, because I'm a Hong Konger, because I'm a Hakka, and then because I'm an overseas Chinese. But she never mentions about the word Indonesia, because I feel Indonesia is about, in everybody's image, is a single tag. It seems like, oh, is your mom a foreign worker? Yes, or a foreign bride. Maybe she thinks she's afraid when she mentions about Indonesia, because she thinks Indonesia, this word, makes herself equal a foreign worker. Not only Wu avoids the word Indonesian, Walter Chen also admits along her childhood as a mixed-blood kid, a society used the term Southeast Asian transnational marriage at those advertisements written on the wall outside the house. Until she saw the magazine, there's a new term. Chen seems to find an able of explanation for herself as a child of a transnational marriage couple to find a way out. Till the new Taiwanese kid, this term come out, people will just start to concern that, are those people talking about me? Yes, because at that time, most of them are about slow earners or some like special needs family. I would doubt myself that, am I really kind of the child of transnational marriage? Becoming new Taiwanese kids confuses Chen more, eagerly to trying to draw a dark recursion line with those negative labels coming with new terms. But other people have those ideas about those labels you mentioned, Indonesian equals to caretakers, or ask your mom directly, are you a foreign spouse? Yes, is your mom a foreign spouse? Usually this moment will draw the decoration line, or my mom said, oh, I'm a traveling overseas Chinese. I would usually imagine that if you're not a overseas Chinese with your face like you, I wouldn't tell other people to know about, yes, I'm the second generation of immigrants, I think Taiwanese too. But what if my mom is really a foreign worker? What if my mom's an Indonesian or Filipino? So what? What's wrong with that? And those stereotypes come out after the new Taiwanese child term. There are some negative labels I also wanted to at first make a clear distinguish with them, but however I think this kind of distinguish means nothing, that you could never end with it. Helpless messy emotions makes Chen Yuzhen become an author to voice out about writing. Second generations are divided to two kinds. One's very successful with millions of annual income, so it's the glory of a country with the pride of Taiwan. And the other is Indonesian or Vietnamese group, and then what? There'll be what's seen in the social news. But I'm wondering if there's this kind of like me, ordinary, neither with a million annual incomes nor hitting or killing people. People doesn't belong to those two kinds. Would they have a chance to say something? Therefore, I started to find some of those who would never be read magazines or interviewed, or they all depends on the friends of friends, and start to ask them, do they have any thoughts and questions about the environment you live? The new second generation Chance talks about as the children of the new heritages in Taiwan. Having a new term that defines herself, she decided to write about something about new generation. From the interview, there are some interconnections and sparkles from which generation they come to Indonesia. I'm not sure, maybe it's my generation of my mom's grandparents or your mom's grandparents. Actually, I don't know. There's two generations before her. During the interview, Chen found out that she was not looking for her route again, and also to review her and her mom's identity. Yesterday, I interviewed a family from Myanmar. His parents are from Myanmar, yes, and he's very young, just 19 years old. He is in the department pharmacy and medical school. How old is he? He is just 19. He's so young, very excellent. Yes. He lives in Taoyuan. His mom seems to sell Yunnan steamed buns, selling small steamed buns, and making the buns for others to sell made by herself. Yes, made by herself. Chen recalls her development in this story. This new second generation often face that their parents' ages are usually older than other classmates' parents. The conversation between her classmates since she was little made her exclude the parents' meeting in school. Interviewed a lot of new second generations, I found that many people's family, there's only one child in the family, yes, and there's problem of sub-replacement of fertility and death we encountered already. Including my parents, they gave birth when they're older veterans, not only for veterans, because in Indonesia, they didn't get married, and when they come here, their age are older, deliver their children after 30 years old. And we all understand these problems. Parents are with old ages. The problem we face is similar. I thought, hey, there's no good way the topics and conversation between us. We would ask about what your father's alms would be buried, something that, just like that when we're 20 years old. But doing this when 50 years old will do, the second generation are more cautious, although the parents' meeting, Chen had to translate for her mama. Those complicated buried in my heart via the interviews with new second generations again and again. Chen is able to get some intimate friends, and everyone's communicating with Taiwanese and teachers and classmates. Mother will wonder how we use this word. They can't quite understand, unable to follow, and most of the time had to translate for my mom, and not translate it to Indonesian language, but Mandarin again. Like, what does your sparing time mean? Just translate it into Mandarin, simpler for her. Staying in Taiwan for 30 years, Wu's next stage of her life has already built up her own life cycle. And her pride, her daughter Chen, via writing, she's also longing the effect for her during her parents' immigration to voice her of herself and other new second generations to find their new piece of home, a place for life. Can you imagine one person has to manage a 3,700 Pink's restaurant? This tiny lady, Wu Kunling, her grandfather's diplomat in Vietnam after the Vietnam War, the whole family moved back to Taiwan. At that time, the Wu family had all their savings were only enough to rent a small suite in addition to two beds. There's only one table picked up on the road. Until her mom started the restaurant, the situation is getting better, which made Wu, at once starred in TV series, to give up the dream to become a singer and made her mind to take over her parents' restaurant, protected with her husband and her children. Curry rice to me is mommy's cooking. She asks for perfection to do everything differently. I think this is the thing my father taught me. I have to do it everything best. Every mealtime, Wu Kunling would wear a blue Vietnam national costume, kindly greet customers at the counter. Thank you. In spite of her tiny body, she is able to manage a 700-yard restaurant. 37 years old, Wu Kunling is this restaurant's second generation. 3 years ago, her father's health was bad. He planned to close the restaurant. After consideration, Wu decided to hold it to continue her father's precious belongings. If the restaurant was closed, you must be very sad. Yes, of course. Fortunately, Wu Kunling was willing to take over it. Otherwise, it'll be a pity. Every part of this restaurant was brought by us from Vietnam. Wu had a very high standard to their cooking. Every day before the restaurant opens, all kinds of soup dishes prepared by cook she will taste first to make sure the taste is good, then to able to serve to customers as though the request to the service there's no expectations. I would confirm for them. Okay, I confirmed it for him. Please clean up here. Some of the waiters sometimes not very good, didn't meet her request, she would be upset. There were some part-time workers during summer vacation. They will call my sister. Devil's sister, Devil's sister is coming. Hurry up, hurry up. You better hurry up. Wu's short temper is just like her mother's. When they are busy in the restaurant, they're just the same. Not yet, hold on. Not that fast, take it slow. Although the restaurant is now run by her daughter, Mom is always Mom. Every time she was in the restaurant, she couldn't help to look around and give them reminds. Not yet. Wait, wait, not that fast. You haven't can even smell the meat taste of the meat. How do I learn if you speak so fast? Sometimes I'm crying while I'm crying, cooking with tears. I will say Mom didn't scold you at all. Just talk very fast. Her father is slower, with slow pace, but he could do everything well. But I am not. I am quicker, and the cook also think my pace is quick. The boss is rapid. Every time she comes in, my hand will shake. Curry chicken is the signature dish of this restaurant. It's also Wu's parents' first best dish. Her mom passed a good taste of curry chicken with her daughter, and dad's Vietnamese French bread special techniques are passed to son-in-law. From dough, rounding and finishing, each of the steps are carefully done. Just in a holiday, they have to produce 300 and 400 pieces of bread, and all are taken care of by Wu's husband. Freshly baked Vietnamese French bread looks golden and crispy, a beautiful natural spirit, makes people's finger licking. Cutting with knife, under the crispy surface, it is soft inside. It is a special taste of French bread leaks out. Freshly baked Vietnamese French bread looks golden crispy. This kind of food, in fact, is our both fusion. Combining hard work, combining efforts is a kind of something like represent our classic dish without limiting Vietnamese snacks. There are many places of favorite dish, like the blonde burst fish using fresh Vietnamese red fish. After frying, cooking is a little bit curly, with gorgeous variety of veggies presenting a beautiful illusion of fish dancing on the grass. Every time when Wu cooks this dish, she would think about the serious look on her father's face when he cooked it. Because of the insist of the taste, her father didn't allow any mistakes. My father insisted very much, as long as there is a slight problem or something wrong, he would rather not sell, or even pour out the whole pot, or eat by themselves. He would never sell it. Inherited her parents' strictness of cooking, Wu asked herself to do better than her parents. She not only takes care of everything of the restaurant, she's also a mother of three kids. She drives her children to school every day. Everything should be done in limited time. In the early morning, I am busy in the restaurant, and then as a mother, I cook breakfast for my kids. We all eat breakfast at home. After the breakfast, they will call me. I would go home to take them to school. Say goodbye to brother. Bye-bye. Wu has three sons. A twin is 3.5 years old. The youngest is just 8 months old. Although she is busy, she still takes the chance to get along with her son in a short time. Until her sons enter the class, saying goodbye to them, she would go to work with Li Leaf. Bye-bye! As a mother and a manager at the same time, her body couldn't stand it. She was sick. I am very sad. I am reluctant to see her work so hard and take care of kids all by herself. Seeing her like this, I'm very worried. So on that day, she fainted. Seriously, I had said, just close the restaurant. She was too tired and it's not worth it. It's not worth it. Mom's tears is running for her daughter, but Wu didn't want to let her family worry. She comforted her mom instead, and she continues the restaurant. The customers like to eat perilla, so we should get more perilla. Okay, purple, yes. It smells good.Wu's grandfather was a delegated diplomat in Vietnam. After married with a Vietnam woman, in the end of Vietnam War, they took the whole family back to Taiwan. At that time, Wu was just 13 years old. She remembers that her parents brought all their savings going back to Taiwan, but all their money was enough just to rent a small suit. There's two beds aside.And a folded table picked up on the road for their living. Her father worked in the factory. Her mother took care of children in daytime and worked in the night shift in nighttime. Afterwards, her father lost his job. The whole family was down and out. Fortunately, her mom's best dish, curry, encouraged by friends with the idea to open a diner for their living. Good cooking skills wouldn't be lonely.Got by customers' word of mouth, the diner was 40 yards had been expanded, helped Wu's family work out from the downside. Understanding her parents' hard effort, Wu knows to cherish what she has now. In fact, Wu has once starred on TV series with her good singing voice. She had a plan to release an album, but between culinary draw and singing dreams, her preference is to absolutely give out the singing path.Taking over the baton from her parents to run this restaurant well. Singing is just a hobby and interest of my teenage. But I think that cuisine is not just a hobby, there are many duties. Besides that, I want to inherit it, daddy's stuff. My parents, I think this is more important.My mother really loves her much, just hoping she could stride over this restaurant left by her father, develop it better than us. And we will be at her back silently to support her.To Wu, her parents' lives are not just only about a restaurant that simple. They try their best to let Taiwanese to get to know about Vietnam. In the restaurant, all the introductions of Vietnam's sports pod or the showcase of cultural items could also be seen like a small museum, not to mention the decoration are full of exotic atmosphere. When people step in, they will feel like another world.I admire my father a lot. I think even the Vietnam government had awarded him because they think my father promotes Vietnam's culture. Help mommy arrange the flowers lower. Thank you. Every day he would take a flower to put on my head. It looks silly on me. This is old brother and...I guess. Okay, go inside. Let's play inside. Now Wu is very satisfied. She thinks everything she has now is earned by her parents with their whole lives. She will protect it with her heart. In the future, she hopes to take her husband and son to follow her parents' footsteps to introduce hometown culture in Taiwan.Thank you for watching Taiwan is My Home today. We hope to bring you a different touching life.Thank you for joining us today. Taiwan is my home. See you next time.